Hi my awesome people, it's your girl Kiana coming back to you guys with another YouTube video. And if you're new to this channel, welcome, welcome, welcome. So in this video, we're going to be discussing the traits of a Proverbs 31 woman. And fortunately for me, this topic has always been an interest for me as a young lady, because I always wondered, what does God have to say about a woman's character? How should she look? And also, how does she attain beauty on the inside and the outside? So without further ado, let's get into the traits and into the video. A Proverbs 31 woman is a woman of virtue. According to Proverbs 31 verse 10, it says, a wife of noble character, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Noble character. She is spiritual, she is capable, and she is intelligent. Number two, she is a woman of faithfulness. Verse 11, it says her husband can trust her and she will greatly enrich his life. She has secure confidence in herself. Number three, reverence. She is a woman of reverence. Verse 12, it says she brings him good, not harm. Meaning, she comforts her husband and she does no evil to him, only good. Number four, she also is a woman of strength. Coming out of verse 17, she is energetic and strong, a hard worker. Meaning, she has spiritual, mental, and physical fitness. Number five, she is a woman of endurance. Coming out of verse 18, she makes her dealings profitable. Her lamps burn late into the night, meaning she's a late worker. She's gonna work. She's gonna make sure her product, whatever she's trying to deal to you, that it is profitable. She is a woman that is well-rounded. We're on number six. Coming out of verse 19, her hands are busy spinning thread, her fingers twisting fiber. Meaning that she's always working. She's doing something that is productive. Number seven, she is a charitable woman. Coming out of verse 20, she extends a helping hand to the poor and opens her arms to the needy. She's always ready to help somebody. Wow. Number eight, she is a provider. Coming out of verse 21, she has no fear of winter for her household, for everyone has warm clothes. If you're a mother or anybody that's in her household, her husband, she is a provider. She helps take care of them. Everybody is taken care of, meaning she's not looking around her house and everything's all over the place. She is in order. She's organized and everything's put together by her. She's not lazy at all. Woo! Lord, work on me. Number nine, she is well-dressed and she is dressed in fine clothing. Coming out of verse 22, she makes her bedspreads and she dresses in fine lining and purple gowns. Number 10, she is a wife of a good husband. Coming out of verse 23, and it says her husband is well-known at the city gates where he sits with the other civic leaders. Meaning, she only does good to her husband. Just like we said earlier, she is a wife to a good man. Number 11, she is honorable. Coming out of verse 25, she is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs without fear of the future. Meaning that she is strong and secure in her position. And number 12, she is wise. Out of verse 26, it says, when she speaks, her words are wise, meaning she always has wise advice. When you come to her, it's not some trash advice. It's gonna be some good advice. It's gonna be advice that's gonna elevate you and not put you down and put you in a place where God wants you to be. Amen. Number 13, this is also coming out of verse 26. It says, and she gives instructions with kindness. She is nice. When she gives instructions, she is kind, she is respectful. Number 14, she is a good mother. She's a good mother. Coming out of verse 27, it says, she carefully watches everything in her household and suffers nothing from laziness. She's not lazy. She's a working woman. Number 15, she is praiseworthy. Coming out of verse 28, her children stand and bless her. Her husband praises her, which means her family praises her, and many others praises her for the work that she does. Number 16, she is a woman that attains and excels. Coming out of verse 29, it says, there are many virtuous and capable women in the world, but you surpass them all. The daughter of a king, the daughter of the creator, the daughter of God. You surpass them all. And last, lastly, in number 17, the Proverbs 31 woman has the fear of the Lord. Coming out of verse 30, it says, charm is deceptive and beauty does not last, but a woman who fears the Lord will be greatly praised. And what does it mean for a woman to have the fear of the Lord? It means that she is reverently worshiping God. She's always obeying and she's serving God, and she is trusting Him with an all-filled respect. And that is what God has to say about how a woman should be. How should her character be? How should she look towards others? And also, how does she attain beauty on the inside and the outside? So I want to thank you guys for watching this video. And if you like this video, go ahead and like the video right now. Comment, share, and subscribe. And until next time, bye-bye now.